啊，就是去游个泳。
So she said,
You'll swim.
Try.
That would be a good episode. Just swimming with Gong Li. I'm amazed how long you've been acting. When you started this, what was the inspiration to be an actor in the first place?
从小的时候就喜欢这个职业，可能是我的想法是可能当一个音乐老师，可能是那个幼儿园的音乐老师，之后就是考上那个表演系，成为一个演员，但是可能这也是一个我的一个命运吧。So
actually, when she was a little girl, she always like singing and dancing and all those kind of artistic things. So her first dream was to be a musical teacher in the kindergarten. When she grew up, finally she got she learned how to act, to be an actress, and then she said maybe it is her fate.
So did you want to teach because you like kids in particular, or that it just seemed like a profession that was obtainable, or?
因为我家里边都是老师，所以他们也很希望我能够成为一个老师，但是我想我做不了别的老师啊，我比较喜欢唱歌跳舞，那我的父母就说啊，你如果这样的话，你可以当一个音乐老师也很好。然后您又特别喜欢孩子是吗？小孩，我也对，当时也很喜欢，现在也就对孩子来说，其实当时没有想的是一个什么样的老师，但是可能是。 幼儿园的老师比较容易吧。Yes, actually,
because her family, her parents were professor, of university. So she, and then she got, she saw them how they work every day, and then she, so when she was very young, she said, okay, I will become a teacher. And then her parents were very happy, and then they said, okay, so if you want to be a teacher, how about to be a musical teacher, because she sings well and she dances well. So, and then she, at that period, she loves, of course, she loves kids. Mm-hmm. And then also she was thinking, to be a musical teacher in the kindergarten would be quite easy.
Did you go through traditional training to become an actor, or did you just kind of act naturally?
是去的学校，去了北京中央戏剧学院，戏剧的，是舞台的。She
was okay. She was admitted at a academy dramatic institute in China. So she
4年的。
4 years, yes, she stayed there for about 4 years. But afterwards, actually, her game, her aim was to become a theater actress. Was not nothing about the movie at the moment.
So have you gone back to theater during this last number of years, this last 30 years?
Not yet. I will, one day, yeah.
Do you miss it? Is that?
Yeah, yes, of course.
So did you have any idea of fame? Because you really, just from the very beginning, you became kind of a worldwide sensation from your very first film. Was that something that you anticipated in any way?
So have you heard how that she feel, her feeling, right?
Whether she anticipated the idea of being a famous actress as opposed to just a working actress. Was it even in your mind that was a possibility? Was it a consideration?
过您会是成为一个如此著名的女演员吗？还是就是从来就没有想过，就自然而然就这么成了？我想过我会是一个好演员，但是我没有想过是一个什么有名的演员什么，我没有想过。因为考上大学的时候，我的老师说，你是一个很好的一个，你有很好的一个感觉跟对演戏。 但是没有想过是有没有出不出名，我没想那么多。Yes,
and actually at the very beginning, after the examination, to go to the university, and then her teacher told her, you have a very good potential to be a good actress. So she said to herself, okay, I will become a good actress. But she never think about to be famous or glamorous or something.
Was that part of the thinking? I mean, you were a few years, it was a few years after the Cultural Revolution, I guess. It was maybe 7 years after things had stopped that you made your first film. Was there any mindset about being famous in the rest of the world in China? Were any Chinese actors considering this as an issue?
对，他说就是您开始的时候还比较早吧，就是他不太记得年代，但是那个时候可能因为文化大革命就是结束也大概也就是过了八九年的样子还是怎么样，他不太记得年代，但是他是不是在那个年代，作为一个中国的女演员或者是男演员也好，好像你成。
其实那时候是1988年吧，1988年的时候，第一部电影，
87年、88年
的第一部电影，那时候已经有很多的中国很喜欢电影，有很多的中国的演员也在中国来说是很大家很喜欢的，当然在因为那时候还没有改革开放，所以在中国的这个大门还没有完全开放，所以中国电影好像也走不出去。那正好是第五代导演，我跟张艺谋合作之后，那中国第五代导演，我跟随中国的第五代导演走向了国际，那。也没有想那么多是什么出名啊，只是觉得中国电影能够走向国际已经真的已经非常非常觉得荣幸了。
Actually she said she had the chance to meet the number fifth generation director because at that moment it is about her first film was shot in 1987 at that moment in China there were some really good film very goodactor, actress and director already, but she got the chance to go outside China with Zhang Yimou and this good film. And then but really she, frankly, she never think about to be as a famous one, a symbol.
So as you worked together on your first film, did you have a sense that there was something special there, or was it just a first job and normal nerves for an actress doing her first movie?
对，他说您跟张艺谋导演拍的，也就是您的第一部电影，对吧？您当时的感觉就是说，是您有什么特殊的感觉？就是说，好像也就是说，是一个事业的新开端呢、啊？还也就是说，是我的第一份工作？
那个是还在大学一年级，还因为大学四年还早着呢。第一年的时候就，他有一部他的也是张艺谋的第一部电影，他导的第一部电影。当时是一个暑假，我可以放假，我可以出来拍电影。如果不是暑假，可能我也出不来，也不可能请假。所以学校不让，所以我是暑假的时候出来拍的几部电影。拍电影的时候，其实我当时不喜欢电影，因为我觉得我是一个话剧演员，我应该在舞台上去演话剧，我对电影没有任何感觉。拍完以后开始喜欢电影。
Actually, this for her that was quite special because in 1987 that was her first year in the university. And normally in the university we have the regulation. The students they can't ask for a like a sick leave to go to make films. So it was in her summer vacation. So she had the chance to make this film, the first film with Zhang Yimou, and actually it's the first film of Zhang Yimou. Also, as a director, and then at the very beginning, she has no idea about what it is a movie because she was a student for theater. So and then she didn't like movie at all.
You didn't like movies, then?
In the beginning, no.
So did you? Did it was that good for Zhang Yimou? Was that did he like to kind of be in control of all the visual and everything else that you weren't? Did he like you being unconscious? Do you think? Do you like you not being as conscious of where your light was or whatever? Do you think that was to his advantage as a filmmaker?
对，他说那么就是在您
就是完全没有一无所知的情况下，您走进了电影的大门。那么您觉得是不是对张艺谋来说，他可真是太好了，他就可以怎么摆布您啊什么的，就是您都听他的了。
其实那时候我已经是上大学一年级了，学习也不错，学习也非常好，所以呢有一点基础。他选我的时候，其实我们是试过戏的，你不可能说一点基础也没有，是你不会演戏，他也不可能找我。还有一个姜文，那个另外那个演员，他是已经非常出名，也是我们学校毕业的，比我高两级的，他是一个非常好的演员，他现在是导演。就是大家在互相帮助，对我来说，就是我的学习的机会会非常多。拍完这部电影之后，我就知道啊，电影应该是怎么一个表演的方式，它跟舞台有什么样的不一样？你的表情应该是多非常非常细腻的。你在舞台上你离得很远，你可能是要身体语言会比较多，但是在镜头上你可能是你的表情会比较重要。就很多方面我有了很大的变化，很大的改变。也是非常感谢张艺谋，就是把我带进了这个电影世界。
So actually, at that moment, she has no idea about how to make a film, what it is a movie, being as an actress, a movie actress. So it is true, Zhang Yimou showed her a lot, And then at the same time, in this movie, the actor, his name is Jiang Wen, he's a very famous and very good one. So he also showed him how to, follow them, follow their step. She put her own step inside the movie world also. So she's really appreciate about that. So it is because of Zhang Yimou, she entered inside the movie world.
So has the way you work together changed dramatically over the many films and many years?
对，他说，那么你们工作的就是合作方式，这么多年之后是不是已经改变了？就是像最初他引导你啊，还是引导您啊，还是就是您现在就是合作方式和工作方式已经有改变了？
现在我觉得我可以有很多的想法，可以跟他说，因为当时那时候，当然第一部跟现在这一部完全是不一样的，因为大家已经工作这么长时间了，那时候的只是一个学习的阶段，现在很成熟了，有自己的很多的想法，想有自己的那个对这个角色的想法，对这个表演的想法。张艺谋一直他是一个非常那个让演员自由发挥的一个导演，这方面我觉得是他成功的很重要的一个方面吧。所以跟他合作起来一直没有改变，一直是有一个自由发挥的一个空间。到现在为止也是一样的。
After so many years working together, and actually she said now she has more, she has more ideas about the film. So and then as a director, Zhang Yimou is he has a very open mind. So he always leaves lots of freedom for his actor, his actress to work, to create. And then so for her, that's a very good way to cooperate with a director like this.
So how did he present you with this character first?
This character,
the film.
Okay. 他说，那么就是一开始吧，他对于这个电影《婉瑜》是怎么给您介绍这个角色的？
他介绍这个角色的时候，他就说，这个角色你好好看一下吧，别人演不了，只能你来演，怎么演我也不知道，你自己去想吧，我们帮不了你。
So actually, talking about this character in the movie, Zhang Yimou, the first sentence he said,
非常难。
He told her is, I have a very difficult character for you, but you have to research it by yourself.Because I do not know how to do it. I do not have ideas. So do it or whatever you want, but I think this character is only for you.
So he just called you up and said, I have this material and you're the one?
他说，所以他就给您打个电话，就说，哎，我现在有这个剧本，有这堆材料，这个角色就是您的了。 就是这么简单。
嗯，把一本书给了我看，看完之后就说我们会，取他的后半段，差不多50岁到80岁这一段阶段，但是基本上他的戏是这个，是后面是失忆的，这种表演方式没有人可以教你，你只有自己去琢磨这个角色，所以我觉得这是一个非常大的挑战，但是也是我最喜欢的一方面。
So actually, it is something like he gave him the novel, the book,、mm-hmm. and then he said, it's a very good book. And then first you read this book, and then I give you the script, and then I think that is for you. But I have already decided we are not going to film the whole book.、Mm-hmm. We're only going to do between when she's about 50 years old up to 80 years old of this character. But I have to tell you, because 70% of time you are going to lose your memory, so nobody can teach you how to do it.
So when he says to you 50 to 80, is that exciting or horrifying?
I'm so excited.
Less makeup, less of a, or I guess there's more makeup. They have to make you look the age, yes?
Mm. It's 我也很感谢好莱坞的，我们请到最后的是请到好莱坞的那个最好的那个化妆师。我自己的化妆师也很好，就我们中国的化妆师是差不多是之前。前面段是都是我们自己的化妆师，但最老的化妆师是我们请的好莱坞的化妆师，他让我真的塑造了一个很好的形象在最后。这化妆是很重要的，就是化妆、服装还有这个感觉，对一个演员的塑造是非常重要的。
Actually, for her, she's very excited about this challenge. And then talking about this makeup, yeah, of course, she's not going to dress up, but she has to be making up like more, like、mm-hmm. what you say. And then luckily, she has a very good, master of makeup in China,、mm-hmm. but.So this Chinese guy, he had the first part when she was young, and then but from when she got got her problem the memory、mm-hmm. they found the best master of makeup from Hollywood.、Mm-hmm. So is this guy he was like a magician.
So your name is often preceded by.One of the most beautiful women in the world.
Oh, thank you.
Do you have any vanity about that, or is that just what everybody else gets to decide what you look like, or how they rate you, or whatever?
对，他说这个就是您总是被称为世界上最美丽的女人之一嘛。这个是就是您有什么感觉？就是好像就是。这有一个什么评选标准吗？还就是人家就是这么说的，还是就是怎么来的？
我是觉得其实这个标准是不完全是你的外表，我觉得是一个整体的，还有你的工作，还有你的内心世界，还有你的教育，它是一个完整的一个美，它不是完全是一个表面的一个美丽。
So for her, talking about beauty, it is not only how do you look like,、mm. it is also inside. So not only for her, we can't only have a face, we still need to have some brain, and then the way of working, all of that.Her ideas.
So do you like research? Do you do on a role like this when he says, I'm not doing the research, you do the research? Are you in, is that part of your work, or do you kind of like to act it more than think about the detail behind it?
对，他说那么好了，导演跟您说，这个我不管，您就负责管吧。然后您是不是就开始了这个研究工作？就是他说这个研究这种寻找啊，是不是您工作的一个部分？然后您就是觉得就是要去揣摩这个角色嘛？对，您觉得这个过程是？
其实这个过程确实在这个拍戏的这个过程中，我觉得其实挺艰难的，因为这个角色别人帮不了你，真的是别人帮不了你什么。如果你的状态、你的本身的 makeup、你的状态跟你的表演不 不到位或者不够细腻或者不对的话，只有一个失败一个成功，它没有一个中间的阶段，所以压力非常大，需要自己去寻找。而且这个电影不是一个像秋菊打官司这样一个女人的电影，它分三个阶段，分三个人，一个是卢岩石，一个是女儿，一个是我，所以你没有太多的时间去失去这个机会，所以每一点你一点一滴的镜头你都要非常非常的细腻，非常非常的小心，所以在这个表演过程中其实下了很大的功夫。
Yes, actually she, afterwards she was concentrating about this research to take reference to know how these people act, and then she spent about 2 months for this preparation, and then to go inside her world.
When somebody loses their memory and things like that, focus, yes?
Yeah, 他就说，然后就是说您的那个准备了，就是您是怎么去体验生活这一段，就请您谈一下。
就是去医院去差不多一个半月吧，去看了所有那些病人，主要是采访他们的家属，他们在家里的所有的情况，还有就是看了我的那个黄楚钦老师，跟我是跟这个角色是一样的病，还有在表演的过程中，就是我没有机会去浪费任何一个镜头，没有机会，因为他不是一个完整的，就是说一个女人的这个故事。如果我觉得这个女人如果她建立不起来的话，大家不信任她的话，这个电影应该是就是失败的。所以我觉得我的任务非常重，在这个电影里面。
Yes, and then after all, yes, about this researching, actually she used about 2 months, more than 1.5 months, she went to a hospital, especially like a retiring house, to see all those people who had the same disease as Wan Yu, the character in the film. So she goes to see them every day and talk with their family members to know about their daily life, and then try to observe them to see the emotion, reaction, movement, and to see their habits of life. And after 1.5 months, she went to see a very famous Chinese film director, which is a lady. Her name is Huang Shuqin, and she's about 75 years old. She had the same disease as Wan Yu. So that's sad, but she learned a lot from them.
And is the set very uncomfortable? Is it an unhappy set because you're so emotionally intense in this film? Or is it light once you're off between takes? Is it very heavy to shoot the movie? Or is it you do the work and then you're off?
Okay, I understand.对，他说您感觉是就是拍这个电影吗，是就是感觉就是说一直都非常沉重，有一种重负重压的感觉，还是说就是啊好了，我现在拍电影下班，拍电影下班，就是您拍完电影之后您走得出来吗？还是拍摄过程中一直感觉很沉重？
其实一直在没有是沉重，其实一直在这个人物当中。我刚才跟你讲过，你没给他翻译，就是我一直是觉得我没有时间浪费，因为我没有时间浪费任何一场戏一个镜头，因为我这个戏不是完于一个人的。但是如果这个人物不成立的话，这个电影会不成立，那两个人物也不会成立。所以我觉得这个角色对我来说它的重要性很大，而且我觉得我经常是被这个人物感动，就是被我演的这个人物感动，但是有的时候在我表演过程中我是一直用一种笑容，一直用一种很放松的表情，但有的时候我想哭的时候想不能哭不能哭，不能为他，就是不能这个人物，就是最后送饺子那场戏坐到那儿的时候，你真的心是很酸的，你就觉得你不知道这两个人的是什么关系，就是很多这种瞬间吧，就是让我觉得进入这个角色的时候其实我是很幸福的。
Actually, she feel really she can't say she feel heavy to make this movie, but she feels she's really go inside to her world, and also she knows this lady, this character, she's very important. She's in the middle. That's one side is the father, the other side is the daughter. If she failed, and then that's no movies anymore. So she feel the pressure. But at the same time, that's really for her, that's, she also feels the happiness to face the challenge every day. And then she's really impressed by Wan Yu, by the character she made.
And you've seen the movie, I guess.
您看了电影吗?
Yes, of course.
are you comfortable watching yourself work?
Yes. Oh, I like it. Yeah, so I love this movie.
And a great experience to come to Cannes with it?
Mm. 带着这个电影来戛纳是一个愉快的经历吧。
是一个很愉快的经历。我觉得没有参加竞赛，也是一个电影节的一个损失吧。因为一个好电影，是应该让全世界的人去享受的。
Actually, yes, it's a great pleasure to come back with coming home at Cannes. But she thinks that's also a little bit, it is a little bit pity. It's a pity of the festival because such a good film, it is not inside the competition.